Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to learn modal analysis using Ansys Workbench. So whenever we have to perform any dynamic analysis, we are going to find the vibrational characteristics like natural frequencies and mode shapes. So we have to find dynamic behavior of the structures which is responding to the dynamic loading, that means time varying load. So here we are going to find the vibration characteristics between natural frequency and mode shapes. So learning in the video is introduction to modal analysis, then natural frequency and mode shapes, reasons to compute natural modes, overview of natural mode analysis, example using Ansys Workbench, how to generate mode shapes, and result validation. So here we have one of the example which is solved by using mathematical equations, and the same example we have to solve using Ansys Workbench. Then we are going to validate the results. So keep watching this video till the end. So introduction to modal analysis. So modal analysis determines the vibration characteristics, that is natural frequency and mode shape of structure or machine component. So here we have to find the dynamic characteristics, or we can say vibration characteristics, that means natural frequency and mode shapes of a machine components. Then natural frequency and mode shapes are important parameter in design of structure for dynamic loading conditions. So whenever we have a time varying load, in this case we have to find these two characteristics of vibration. So here these are the two important parameter in design in case of dynamic loading conditions. And it also can serve as a starting point for another dynamic analysis, such as harmonic analysis, transient analysis, or spectrum analysis. So this is one of the base analysis or primary analysis for most of the dynamic analysis, like dynamic analysis, harmonic analysis, or transient analysis. So, and if in this case mostly we omit the damping, but if there is damping in the structure or machine component, the system become a damp modal analysis. So in this case, to find these characteristics become very complex. So generally we omit this damping to the structures. So the below here the figure is indicating the first is physical domain, that is your one of the column we can see, and after reaching the natural frequencies first, second, third, the shape of the structure is going to change. So this is the mode shape 1, 2, 3 and mode shape number n is shown in the figure. Then what is mean by natural frequency and mode shape? It is very important to understand these two concepts, because these are the very basic parameters we require for design for any dynamic analysis. Therefore, we have to understand it very deeply. So here, the natural frequency of a structure are the frequency at which structure naturally tend to vibrate if it is subjected to disturbance. Whenever we create any disturbance to the structure, then at certain frequency occurs and our structure is going to vibrate at that frequency, that is known as your natural frequency. And the deformed shape of the structure at that specific natural frequency of vibration is termed as its mode shape of the vibration. So at particular frequency our structure is get deformed to particular shape, that specific frequency is known as, that particular shape is known as your mode shapes. So natural frequency and mode shape are function of natural frequency, structure property, and boundary conditions, right? So your these natural frequency and mode shapes are the function of structure property like Young's modulus, and it also depend on boundary conditions. And if structural property changes, the natural frequency changes, but mode shapes may not necessarily changes. So it is not like that when we change any properties like Young's modulus of the material, or then in this case our natural frequency may get changed, but it is not necessary that our mode shape also get changes, right? But if in case boundary condition changes, then natural frequency and mode shape both changes. So here is the example is shown in this diagram. Here we have two beams, that is cantilever beam and simply supported beam. Here the boundary condition for this beam is different. Therefore, mode shape is also different and natural frequency is also different. So as the boundary condition changes, both the natural frequency and mode shape rate changes. So some may ask that why we need to compute these natural modes, that is natural frequency and mode shapes. So because there are a number of reasons, so I have listed four main reasons to compute natural modes. The first reason is to assess dynamic interaction between the component and its supporting structures. So what do you mean by that? If let's consider example of air conditioning fan, it is attached to the window of your building. And if the operating frequency or excitation frequency of that fan is matches with your window of the building, then your window is going to fail. So we have to calculate this interaction between this component and supporting to avoid the resonance, to avoid the failure of the structures. This is the first reason. Let's move to the second reason. So results from model analysis can be used for subsequent dynamic analysis. So whatever results we obtain, that is natural frequency or mode shapes, from the model analysis, that can be used for subsequent dynamic analysis, like your random frequency analysis or harmonic analysis. So this is kind of base analysis. Whatever results we obtain, that we are going to use that to the subsequent dynamic analysis. The third reason is the result of the dynamic analysis are sometimes compared to the physical result test results. So whatever results we obtain from the dynamic analysis, we have to compare with your, we have to validate that result with our physical test results. So it will validate the results. So in this case also, it can be used to validate the results with your physical test results. This last reason is here, natural mode analysis can often provide an indication to design changes if needed. So whenever we find natural frequency or mode shape, it will show you if it is too near your resonance or is there need to change any design parameters. Likewise, if our natural frequencies or our vibration or our excitation frequency is near to your natural frequency, then we have to make some changes in the design. So it will also indicate that model analysis also indicate in design changes. So in summary, so we should have understanding of natural mode analysis and we should know the deep knowledge of natural frequency and mode shapes for particular structure for all types of dynamic analysis. So overview of natural mode analysis. So the equation of motion for natural mode with no damping and applied loading is m u double dot plus k u equal to 0. So here damping equation and load is missing because it is a equation of undamped free vibration. That means we have not considered the damping and applied loading. Therefore, it is a simplified equation for undamped free vibrations. And here m is a mass matrix, k is a stiffness matrix. And solving above equation by using the harmonic solution, here we get a simplified equation, that is u equal to displacement equal to phi sin omega t. So here phi is equal to eigenvector or mode shape, we can say. So eigenvalue and eigenvector, this is a very known parameter in vibration analysis. So eigenvector means your mode shapes, and here omega is a circular natural frequency, right? So alpha or lambda is equal to, sorry, lambda equal to omega square is equal to eigenvalue. So eigenvalue is your square of natural frequency, and phi is your eigenvector, that is your mode shapes. Then this is an example I have searched on the internet, and this is a cantilever beam having the cross section B into D. B is a breadth and D is a diameter, sorry, depth here. And your length of the beam is 450 mm, breadth is 20 mm and depth is 3 mm. And material is going to use a structure steel having the Young's modulus is 210 GPa. And constant we are going to use here fixed support at one of the side face. And output we are going to find here natural frequency and mode shape, that is 6 numbers. So this is the example I have taken from the internet source, and this is also solved using the mathematical equations. So at the end of this video I am going to compare the result that is obtained from mathematical as well as that is obtained from the ANSYS workbench. So let's start our AnsiBar bench, and we are going to solve this same problem using AnsiBar bench, giving the same loading condition and boundary conditions in the boundary conditions instead of loading conditions in the AnsiBar bench. So create open AnsiBar bench window here and create model analysis system in the process schematic. So here we can rename the given analysis team, or we can keep it at is. And next we have to change the material property here for this open engineering data. So default material is structural steel. So we have to check the properties like Young's modulus is here. Young's modulus is 200 GPa. So here we have to change this to 210 instead of 200. So replace this 0 with 1. Right. Then density is 7850. It is also same with our example. So this is done with our material, then close engine data. Then we have to create geometry by using this design modeler. So right click on geometry cell. And open view design geometry. So this is our design modeler window is ready. We have to create a rectangular cross section. For this, click on this XY plane and orient this XY plane to the view screen. Click on this look at, then click on sketching, then select rectangle tool from the draw toolbox and create a rectangle. So here view dimensions, the breadth equal to 20 and depth equal to 3. So here 3mm and breadth equal to 20mm. So in this way we have created the rectangle cross section with dimension 20 by 3. Then click on this iso ball for isometric view, then click on modeling mode and select extrude feature toolbox, and here select the geometry and apply. Next we have to do the depth, which is equal to 450 mm, right? And click on generate. So in this way we have created the cantilever beam with the given dimensions. Then we have to close this design modeler. Then open mechanical window. For this, double click on this model cell. So here our mechanical window is ready. Let's check geometries here. This is geometry. Then material. We have to see the material, assign material. So assignment for this geometry is structural steel. Then we have to create the mesh. For this, instead of default element size, we are going to change it to 5mm as a element size. Then create or generate mesh. So right click on mesh and generate mesh. So here I only change the element size, that is 5mm instead of default element size. So here our meshing is ready with a very good element is created in the mesh. Here under the modal node you will find a pre-stress, that is we don't have any pre-stress simulation, so it is none. Then below that we can find analysis setting. So click on this analysis setting and details of analysis setting window. The first option is a maximum node to find, so here 6. So default number of modes we are going to find is 6. So we can change it to 3, 4, 5, 8, 10 as per our convenience. So here I am going to keep it 6. Right, then after this search, limit search to range. So here default setting is no. So that means it is asking for the range in between you want to find the mode shapes. Suppose if you give the range that 0 to 100, that means it is going to search the mode shapes only between the frequency 0 to 100. So I am going to keep it as no. Then next is damped. So it is an undamped modal analysis, therefore the setting is you want to keypad as a no, then this is only settings we can turn in this analyst setting, but for the first analysis we are going to keep it is default. Then right click on solution and right click and solve. So before that we have to give the fixed support here. So click on this model, then right click or click on this support, select fixed support, and here it is asking for geometry. We have to select the side surface, that is model side surface. So select this side surface and click on apply. So fixed support is given to the geometry. Then click on this solution and click on this solve. So whenever we are going to find natural frequency in mode shape, we don't want to we don't need to give the loading conditions. We only want to give need to give the boundary conditions. So as we change the boundary conditions, then again natural frequency also gets changes. So therefore, whatever the conditions we have, we have to apply that condition, and for that we have to find the natural conditions and mode shapes. So here candidate beam which is fixed. Therefore, we have used the fixed support. So here our solution is ready. So you can find in the right bottom corner the tabular data. So here modes one are the given. So we are asking for the 6th number of mode. Therefore, it has created generated 6 modes, right? And for this number of frequency, it is showing to us. It is the first mode having the frequency is 12.42. hertz, and for the second mode it has 77.83 hertz. Then we can create the mode shapes by using this frequency. For this we have to click on this empty cell, then it will going to select all the frequency. Then right click on the these cells and we have to select from the shortcut menu as create mode shape results. So it is going to add below this solution node. So again right click on solution and we select evaluate all results. So when we create these modes, that means it is going to find this total deformation or mode shapes. So for the first frequency, that is 12.42, our mode shape is like this. So here view is to see the mode shape. So click on this animation, apply this animation, so you will see the deformation or the mode shape for the first frequency, for natural frequency. So your first natural frequency is our 12.423. similarly for the second natural frequency we have the mode shape like this. So in this way we can predict or we can find the natural frequencies and mode shapes for the particular structures according to their boundary conditions. So these are the 6 natural conditions we have with us for a given structures. So same results I'm going to compare with a mathematical model. So here so move back to our presentation. So here we have two results with us, that is mathematical analysis and second is computational analysis, that is done by using ANSYS Workbench. So this is the first frequency we got, right, 12.43. you can see here 12.42, right? The second, similarly the same frequency we have obtained by using this mathematical equation, that is equation of motion. This is a simplified equation. This is obtained by using the this data, right? So according to these dimensions and material properties and fixed supports, so here these results is find out by these mathematical equations. So for the first natural frequency we have frequency, that is 12.37 hertz, it is by mathematical equation. Similarly the 12.42, it is by computational, that is means ANSYS Workbench. So it is very close to one another. Similarly, for the second natural frequency, we have 77.53 using mathematical equation, and similarly 77.83 hertz by using this Nancy Bourke bridge. So here we have only two natural frequency by using these mathematical equations or analysis. Therefore, I am going to consider only two natural frequencies. But in the software, we have calculated total 6 natural frequencies. So in this way, we can compare or validate these natural frequencies. Similarly, we have mode shapes. So this is obtained by using these mathematical equations. And similarly, we have seen here by using this animation. Suppose select your first mode shapes and play this animation, and you can see the deformation or mode shape for the first natural frequency. Similarly, we have obtained the same mode shapes by using the mathematical equations. And for the second natural frequency, we get the same mode shapes. So in this way, we validate the mode shape as well as our natural frequencies. So this is way how to find the natural frequencies, or we can say vibration characteristics of the any structures like natural frequency and mode shapes. So this is a very basic example I have taken here to gain some confidence how to proceed with this modal analysis, how to find these parameters for base parameter for the subsequent analysis like complex one analysis like random analysis or spectrum analysis. So in this way we can gather some experience or some confidence to do the more complex example. So this is zip validation, and it's the end of this tutorial. So if you like my video, please subscribe and share. Thank you for it.